Greetings. This is another video on the topic, God has sons by the tons. This video is different because I am going to prove Islam is right. God does have sons by the tons.
What?
Am I saying Islam is right? Not in general. I am saying that on this accusation that the Bible teaches God has sons by the tons, Islam has struck upon a deep truth, but for the wrong reasons. What does the Word of God say? Romans 8:29. For whom he did foreknow, he also did predestinate to be conformed to the image of his Son, that he might be the firstborn among many brethren. Colossians 1:15. Jesus, who is the image of the invisible God, the firstborn of every creature. Colossians 1:18. And he is the head of the body, the church, who is the beginning, the firstborn from the dead, that in all things he might have the preeminence. Here God has just revealed why. Why did Jesus need to be the firstborn from the dead? That in all things he might have the preeminence. Christians, pay attention here. Too often we call ourselves God's children, without serious thought of what that implies. And there is an issue that has caused confusion in the Christian world for the last century. The concept of being born again. Yet this is something Jesus clearly stated in his teachings. John 3:1. There was a man of the Pharisees named Nicodemus, a ruler of the Jews. The same came to Jesus by night and said unto him, Rabbi, we know that thou art a teacher come from God, for no man can do these miracles that thou doest, except God be with him. Jesus answered and said unto him, Verily, verily, I say unto thee, except a man be born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God. Nicodemus saith unto him, How can a man be born when he is old? Can he enter the second time into his mother's womb and be born? This is a confusing subject to the carnal mind. This means a mind filled with secular thinking, thoughts that are not spiritual. Jesus answered, Verily, verily, I say unto thee, except a man be born of water and of the Spirit, he cannot enter into the kingdom of God. That which is born of the flesh is flesh, and that which is born of the Spirit is spirit. Marvel not that I said unto thee, Ye must be born again. Notice Jesus speaks of two births, born of water and of the Spirit. He then repeats and clarifies this duality. That which is born of the flesh is flesh, and that which is born of the Spirit is spirit. The wind bloweth where it listeth, and thou hearest the sound thereof, but cannot tell whence it comes and whither it goes. So is every one that is born of the Spirit. Nicodemus answered and said unto him, How can these things be? Jesus answered and said unto him, Art thou a master of Israel, and know not these things? You Christians, pay attention here. You may have gone to church your whole life, and not been told you must be born again. Just like Nicodemus, a master of Israel, even he did not know this part of the message of the prophets. You must be born again. Look back a moment at John 3:6. That which is born of the flesh is flesh, and that which is born of the Spirit is spirit. The Greek word born used here is, I'm going to mangle this word, gegenimenon, meaning which is begotten. We are begotten by the Spirit, just like we are begotten in the flesh. 1 Peter 1:23, being born again, not of corruptible seed, but of incorruptible, by the Word of God, which liveth and abideth forever. Islam is right about the sons of God, sons that God has by the tons. When we are born again, We are adopted by God into a relationship with Him as sons and daughters. We are born of the incorruptible seed of the Word of God. Romans 8:15, "For you have not received the spirit of bondage again to fear, but you have received the spirit of adoption, whereby we cry, Abba, Father." The spirit of adoption is the Holy Spirit, the Comforter, that Jesus promised to send. The Comforter is that spirit of adoption, the Holy Spirit. Galatians 4:4, "But when the fullness of time was come, God sent forth His Son, made of a woman, made under the law, to redeem them that were under the law, that we might receive the adoption of sons." Ephesians 1:5, "Having predestinated us unto the adoption of children by Jesus Christ to Himself, according to the good pleasure of His will." You see, God wanted to do more than redeem man from sin. God wants to adopt men and women as His sons and daughters. God has established a way for you to have a relationship with Him, with Almighty God. This is the good news, the true Injeel, the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ, the Messiah. This is His message. This is not only good news, this is great news. It is God's salvation. It is news that Satan hates. It is news Satan wants to hide. Does God have sons by the tons? Absolutely, through adoption, by being born again. Christians, know that God has adopted you into His kingdom. This message is the true Injeel, the good news from God. And this is the message Islam was created to counter. Satan cannot stop you from being born again once you decide you want to be. He can only try to never let you find out this is an option for you. You who call yourself Muslim, know that the true Injeel is the message of salvation Jesus brought to give you new birth in God. Know that the true Injeel is the message Satan spawned Islam to cloud and hide and attack. And this religion, Islam, is the web of lies woven to bind and blind you. You are told to say you believe the Injeel, but you do not know what the Injeel is. And the message you are told confirms the Injeel, absolutely rejects the Injeel, and tricks you to hate it and reject it. Does God have sons by the tons? Absolutely. And even if you call yourself Muslim, God wants to invite you to be adopted into relationship with Him. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ, who brought you good news, an opportunity to be adopted as a son. Amen.